Education Days and get to meet some of the superstars of those titanic events in mathematics, in science, in spelling, the whole shebang. It's very, very exciting to have them here amongst us, and we'll be meeting them in just a few moments. It's all due to the work of one man and his many as Tim Power. A big round of applause.
Thanks, Adam. Nothing speaks like the images of the event itself, and so before I formally welcome everyone, I thought we'd present a montage of the World Education Games from 2000.
Best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock,
yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself
standing in the Hall of Fame,
yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name. You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
Politicians, be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders. Be astronauts, be champions. Be truth seekers. Be students, be teachers. Be politicians, be preachers,
preachers.
Be believers, be leaders. Be astronauts, be champions.
Standing in the Hall of Fame,
yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
In 2005 as a local event, challenging students to answer 10 million questions. One of the 3P Learning team members was the teacher of the winning school of that inaugural event, which grew into a Trans-Tasman Bledisloe Cup with New Zealand and a mathematical ashes between Australia and England. Well, Maths Day bloomed from these events in 2007, and as the event virally grew and grew, it transformed into the World Education Games. And what we've come to see clearly is the things that make this event successful are not the competition, or the winners, or the medals, or the World Cups, all no doubt very important. But the things that connect us, that bind us, that give us cause to provide opportunity to students from all walks of life and all parts of the globe. This is the students' event, where they are being matched in head-to-head learning challenges, blogging, tweeting, composing music, appearing in the media on YouTube, or S-penning around the world on their Galaxy Notes, as they strive for excellence. To all of the 3P team members here, and who sadly couldn't be here, they are a remarkable team, and I thank them for their brilliance, selflessness, and dedication. I hope everyone here will get a chance to meet some of those 3P team members at the lunch afterwards. And most importantly of all, I'd like to congratulate all our champion students here. It's hard enough to be top of your class, and it's even rarer to be top of your school. But to be top of your state, or your country, or the world, is a remarkable achievement, and I congratulate them all.
The Honourable Peter Garrett, Mr. Tim Power, Mr. Tyler McGee, Ms. Kate Moore, ladies and gentlemen, and fellow winners, good morning. I'm delighted to be here in Sydney today, that too in the iconic Sydney House, so thank you for inviting me. You see, it's always been a dream of mine to visit Sydney, ever since I first saw the movie Finding Nemo. Although it has taken a much longer time, and I had to take a slightly different route to get here, I can assure you, my journey has been equally adventurous, fun, and very rewarding, to say the least. Life for me has been quite different since becoming a champion of champions. I must say, it's quite nice for a 14-year-old to be widely recognised throughout his school. And trust me, fellow champions, the same will happen to you too. This room is filled to the brim with winners. And I believe it is our duty as champions to share our experiences with those who are hesitant to take part and show them just what they're missing out on. So what has the World Education Games given me? Quite a lot, actually. Being a champion is just the icing on the cake. It has made learning fun, interacting with thousands across the globe. I've made wonderful friends, won trophies and gold medals. And by the way, I tactically place my gold medals directly opposite the entrance to my room, so they're always there on display every time anyone dares to enter the labyrinth of mess that is my room. As an ambassador, I've been showered with gadgets, thanks to Samsung, and the media exposure and experience is something which can only benefit me in the future. Funnily, WEC has also contributed to my all-round development in a way. You see, I realised very early on that a kid who's just good at maths and science may not have the easiest time at school. So I developed my other facets. I now play rugby for my school. I play golf on the Scottish Junior Tour. I practice Taekwondo and I play the saxophone. So, you see, in its own way, WEG has played a major role in giving me a better perspective of life. Hence, I have to thank, first of all, my teachers at the Glasgow Academy, the WEG team, everyone associated with 3P Learning, and Mr. Tim Power in particular, for making this a very special moment for me. It's been a privilege to be your ambassador, and an absolute pleasure to be a competitor in the Games. But most of all, I have to thank you for providing me with a certain street cred. Because now, I can walk up to any rap star, whether it's Snoop Dogg or Jay-Z, and tell them, you think you've got bling? Dude, check this.
You're incredible all-round talent, Sharan. I'm just very thankful that you can't play cricket, because we're going to have enough trouble over there. As it is, please say hello to Jay-Z for me next time you do it, just hanging in the labyrinth.
I was reflecting on the knowledge that you have and your expertise as I came down here from my office in Sydney. And one of the things I wanted to leave with you as a little message and a memory of today is actually the building that you are sitting in and that you know quite well, because it is an iconic Australian site. This building is the product of somebody's imagination. They were trained and skillful as an architect. The person's name was Jorn Utzon. But it was really their imagination that has left us with this extraordinary opera house. And I want to encourage all of those young students who are here today to think about what knowledge and imagination can create. And that's why I've got to say that the World Education Games are a fantastic initiative, and I'm so pleased to be here today to make these awards. So excited to see how these games are becoming a huge global event. Adam's right, there's much more to come. For the moment, welcome to everybody here. Congratulations to those winners, and thank you very much for coming.
You can be a jewel, you can be the world, you can talk a jack, get it banging on your mind. You can say it.